श्रीमती रमान जय नमः। अखिल हेय प्रत्यलीक कल्याण गुणैक तानस्य पुरुषोत्तमस्य हरेः सत्य दिव्य संकल्प जनिते इमे विचित्रमये प्रपंचे सेदर समस्त जीव विलक्षण चैतन्य संपन्न सजीवानां आर्तिहरः देवपितृ ऋषीणां दोषकारकः संज्ञान प्रज्ञान विज्ञान सत्तया प्रकृति पुरुष परम पुरुष तत्वावगाहन प्रतीति विचिति प्रगति प्राप्त्यादि विषयेषु समर्थः नर एव सर्वोन्नत इति श्रूयते दृश्यते च एतादृशेषु नरेषु अपि अनादि जन्म द्वंद्व वासनया विभिन्नाः विभेदाः दरीदृश्यन्ते यथा मनुष्याणां देह वैलक्षण्यमस्ति तद्वत् देश वैलक्षण्यमपि परिगण्यते बुधैः यथा भूमौ धातुरसद्रव्यादीनां नानारूपाणाम् आधिक्यं नैयून्यम् अभावादिकं विभिन्नेषु प्रान्तेषु अवलोक्यन्ते तद्वत् मानसिक बौद्धिक आध्यात्मिक अनुकूलता अनुष्ठान अनुकूलता शक्तिः प्रख्याते अस्मिन् भरतमण्डले भारते देशे एव विलसति इति सर्वेषाम् एककण्ठाभिप्रायः अत एव नरस्य देहसम्बन्धः उत् तस्य नरस्य भारतन्नाम देशसम्बन्धात् सः उत्तरः तत्रापि देशाचारसंस्कृतीनां स्वरूपानुरूप अनुष्ठानसम्पत्तिः सिद्ध्यति चेत् सा एव उत्तमः इति श्लाघ्यः इति सर्वेषां महर्षीणां सदात्मनाम् अभिप्रायः विकसिते समाजे प्रवहन्ति असङ्ख्येयाः गुणाः धर्माश्च यथा सत्य अहिंसा प्रीति क्षमा धैर्य वीर्य श्री धी भूति प्रभृतीनाम् आयतनं भवति तत्क्षेत्रं तद्वत् सर्वे सभ्यतालक्षणानि सर्वाणि सभ्यतालक्षणानि यथा ज्येष्ठानां श्रेष्ठानां गौरवं स्त्रीणामपि पूजनं गौरवञ्च ज्ञानसम्पत्तिः धर्मचिन्ता धर्मविचारः एवं विधियुक्तराष्ट्रपरिपालनम् एवं परतत्वविवेकदेवताराधन इष्टिप्रभृत्यादयः सर्वे अस्माकं राष्ट्रे एव विलसन्ति इति अस्माभिः अनुभूयते एव अत एव सर्वेषां धर्माणाम् आश्रयः तपोभूमिः ज्ञानभूमिः क्रियाभूमिः कर्मभूमिः इति अस्माकं स्थानमेव संस्तुयते अत एव शास्त्रेषु भाषा एव भाषमानानां जनानां कुलवंशपरम्परागत संस्थिति स्थिति परिस्थिति उन्नति प्रकृतिविषयिक प्रदर्शक आदर्शः तेषां मूल्यतत्त्वनिष्कर्षनिकष इति अभिप्रियते विद्वद्भिः अत एव तासु भाषासु भाषाविषये तु स्वरूपवैशिष्ट्यं विद्यते विषयवैशिष्ट्यं विद्यते भाषायाः स्वरूपं तु माधुर्यं लालित्यं सारल्यं गाम्भीर्यं स्वातन्त्र्यम् इत्यादयः भाषासु विद्यमानानां ग्रन्थानां प्रतिपादनविषयाणां गौरवविषयेपि अस्माकं संस्कृतभाषायाः वैशिष्ट्यं जगत्प्रसिद्धमेव विद्यते इति एतैः कथितम् अत एव सर्वोन्नतभाषा जगति संस्कृतभाषा एव इति निर्मत्सराणां सतां मतं विद्यते अत्र विद्यमानानां संस्कृतविषये अनभिज्ञानां सर्वेषां जनानां सुखतरसरल सुगम अवगमनाय आङ्ग्लभाषायामपि मया किञ्चित् उच्यते समाप्यते च उच्यते हि प्लवङ्गमानां जन्म श्रीरामावतारस्य अनन्तरं ये तत्र प्लवङ्गमजन्तवः सामान्यतः परिहासास्पदा आसन् रामावतारस्य अनन्तरं ते सर्वे श्लाघनीयाः हनुमत्तत्वेन पूजनीयाः अभवन् तद्वत् वयमपि संस्कृतस्य माहात्म्यम् उक्त्वा आङ्ग्लभाषां वैदिकयामः पवित्रीकुर्मः It has been well explained by the previous speakers about the greatness of the Sanskrit. Each and every person pertaining to a culture, a civilization, or pertaining to your way of life or code of life, he has two duties. One is to get all the benefits from the attachment, to get fame, to get name, to earn reputation, to get honor, and to be well established by wealth and prosperity by the tradition to which he is attached, that everybody is doing very perfectly. Each and everybody attached to a language and religion or a culture and tradition, they are earning name, fame, reputation and establishment from that. But in turn to that, his own contribution is of two types. One is samrakshana, second is poshana. When that particular dharma or the system of operation where he is attached to, if it is founded to be declined, then he has to support it with all of his might. That is poshana. Whenever there is an accusation, whenever there is a protest, whenever there is even a trace of blemish that is trying to be accusated on it, a person should try his level best to sacrifice anything for the reinstallation of the glory of his tradition. So that is paritrana and poshana. These things are the two eyes by which we can show the magnitude of our gratitude towards our culture. This Sanskrit is also having a lot of blemishes, which are known as adhyaropas, which are on that. And we have to understand that, number one, it is Brahmanyavada. Everybody says that it is belong only to the Brahmins. So the other sects of the people are totally against it. And it is having different sampradayas. The Kavya tradition is different. The Shastra tradition is different. Kala tradition is different. Bhasha tradition is different. The Amna tradition is different. There are limited types of admissions and limited types of demarcations in various systems. I think that it requires a very great seminar separately to be exclusively organized for vichara of all of these things. But what I want to say is, it requires lot of felicitations like austerity, penance, celibacy and various other principles which bring them the Brahminhood. So Brahminhood is brought 1/4 by the birth, 2nd 1/4 by the samskara as a rituals, 3rd 1/4 by the practices, 4th 1/4 by the transformation of a person's characteristic splendor. So Brahmanya is all encompassing, number one. Number two, somebody said that it is Mrita Bhasha. Even we can take it in the form of Abhyugamyavada. What is Abhyugamyavada? Even if you accept that it is Mrita Bhasha, there is no problem, because it is not that we can say that all people who have left the world, they are all bad incels, all those who are living, they are all superior in status. Number one. And number two, due to Kalipolahala Kallola Kalka, what we call the mysterious, the rampance of the period of the present era, lot of the things which are very much useful, which are very much provocative to the society, we have lost lot of things. Lot of great things we have lost in the era of time, in the wash of the tide of the time. Likewise, lot of unwanted things are still existing. That's what the Shastra say, that Anarhana Vishyanam Bahulyam Pracharaha Vyaptischa. Arhana Vishayanam Kshayaha Bhangaha Apamana Tiraskaranadayaha. So even worthy things are neglected and they are diminishing, and unworthy things are ruling and they are all pervading. So something which exists and which is permeable, that need not be considered to be great. Only for the reason that it is not existing or it is extinct, it need not be considered to be something unworthy. So what we want now is, if something is great, it is our duty, just as if we lose our health, we try our level best to bring it back. If you lose